What's going on, YouTube? Welcome to Lux Lumen GR. Today we'll be doing a review on the Matminco CSF02 mini keychain light. This little mini keychain light right here has three LEDs. It has two secondary LEDs and it has a main LED, which is the XPG3 LED. This left one here, or my right on this side here, is an UV light, and this one is a red light for reading and at night reading maps, such stuff like that. Now, in order to turn this thing on, you guys will see two buttons right there. Top button has a power switch on it, or the power symbol on it. That is actually to operate the two secondary lights, and the arrow right here with the little grippies on it, that is to operate the main light itself. So we'll start off with the user interface for the secondary light. You hold the button down until they pop on. So right there is your UV light. Now, if I had something around here to show you guys how good this UV is, I'd be able to show you, but I'll demonstrate that in just a second. Now, what you do is you press the button again and it jumps to a red light, which is for reading at night, stuff like that. Let me grab this little box here so you can see for reading at night, stuff like that. The military use it for reading maps while being in the truck, stuff like that. So this is a good reading light for at night while you're in a car, at home, stuff like that. Now, in order to turn the secondary lights off, you hold the button down again and eventually just shut right off. So now to turn on the main one, you have to hold down this button right here, and then boom, it jumps straight to the highest mode, which is 250 lumens. Then you press the button once more, and drops down to 210 lumens. Press it once more, drops 250 lumens. Press it once more, drops down to 40 lumens, which is perfect for at night, at your bed, you know, leaving your bedside, stuff like that, going to the restroom, walk through the house where it's nice and dark. It's a perfect little light for that. And then simply to turn it off, you just press the button, and there you go, that's where you have it. Now also, this is a USB rechargeable light. USB, we'll go through that, and I'll also show you guys the UV in a second. Well, you also come in three other colors aside from the rainbow. You have a silver, a black, and you have a blue. Nice shiny blue. Let me see. Nice brushed stainless steel on that one, and a nice brushed black on this one. Now, there is no instructions that come with the box itself or inside the box. Literally just everything is on the back right here. So there is the back with the instructions, the features, the parameters, the output runtime intensity, the distance, the impact resistance, and the waterproof. So I'll pause. You guys can pause it right there. You guys can check it out. It's actually a pretty very handy light. Like I said, look at no bigger than a key fob. No, it fits just like, I mean, it'll fit right in your pocket like a key fob, fit on your keychain like a key fob. It's actually lighter than a key fob, so there should be no inconvenience on that when it comes to the weight. Now, this may also look familiar, like another light out there. These guys are actually the main manufacturers of this light. Then what they did is they rebranded it for Banggood as the Astrolux K1. So the Astrolux K1 is also the Matminco CSF02. So like I said, it has the charging port right here. I'm going to move these guys out of the way. Move this stuff out of the way. And I'll show you guys how this whole charging port works. I will pull my little charging thing up here. Put that up there. Nice little charging unit right here for charging up stuff, all your for your phones, stuff like that. So simply just lift the tab up like that. You will put this on, and it'll start blinking red. Now, blinking red means it's charging, and now when it starts blinking green, that means it is fully charged. So right now it is charging. You can also use it while it's charging without any issue at all. Now, I've also charged this unit itself with my my charger for my Samsung phone, which is, it charges at 2 amps, and it's never, I didn't, never damage this thing at all, as far as I know. So no issues there at all with damaging it, as far as I know. Maybe in long-term use of charging it at 2 amps, it might charge it, but It does not say anything on here as to what the charging input should be for the light itself. So I'm going to take my chances and just keep on using my charger or use this little guy right here. So there you go. That is the demonstration for the charging. And like I said, it will go to a red when it's charging and then to a blinking green when it's fully charged. Now, I'm going to stop the video for a second. I'm going to grab some stuff that glows in the dark. I'm going to test out the UV light and also the red light. Okay, guys, we are back to test out this all UV light on the Matminko CSF02. What I have here is my Gankank, got my hat, and I got a glow-in-the-dark, one of my little kid's toys right here, my daughter's toys. Glow-in-the-dark, I guess it's a moth or a butterfly. So I'm going to turn the lights off. It's going to get dark in here, and we will check this thing out. One more click. There we go. So now we are going into, that's red, and now we're in UV mode. So there you go. There's the Gankank lighting up. Here's my hat lighting up. I'm holding this thing about 3 feet off the objects themselves. So you guys can tell everything is glowing pretty. Look at that thing glow. It's really good. Glow in the dark. Let's see if it'll move. Oh yeah, it charges up glow in the dark stuff for sure. So very convenient, especially when in hotel rooms and stuff like that. It'll shine up anything that's I guess you can say organic or has a fluorescent tint to it. I will actually probably bring you guys down to the laundry room really quick and show you guys the glowy dark stuff on the from all the soaps. Some soaps have fluorescence and UV light inside of it, so they're not UV free anyways. We'll check that out, and then we'll go to the I want to jump to the red right now first. So there's the red. That's for at night for reading. Let me grab this list right here that has some codes on it for certain lights. So I can see it perfectly. It's kind of washed out a little bit on the screen, but there's some special codes for some lights if you guys happen to see it. See that code right there? It says Astrolux K1. It's BBDEB5. So you guys can save some money on this light, the Astrolux version, of course. So we will stop this and we'll go down to the laundry room. All right, guys, we are in the laundry room right now. And I'm going to show you guys how this thing works. Exactly how well it works. Looks like somebody dropped some soap down there. You guys can see all the nasty stuff in here, all the fluorescence from the actual laundry detergent itself. Runs down the side, the back. I think it's glowing like crazy. But yeah. Let's see if you guys see the lint back there. And then there's some stuff inside the garbage can, so looks like Frosty the Snowman's face. The hat on. That's pretty funny, but I'm holding it about 4 feet above that. It's making it glow very well. So instead of an actual room itself, where this light gets to spread out, it'll glow pretty good. There's that spot again. See all the stuff around here. Wow, this person was really messy. But yeah, this UV light works great. So what we're going to do is we're going to jump into the regular light modes in here as well. So I'm going to turn on to, should jump right up to 250 lumens. 250 lumens, 210, 150, and then there's your 40 lumens. Like I said, it's perfect for walking at night inside the house. Press the button again, right back to 250 lumens. So this thing is actually pretty bright for a keychain light. Works awesome. Can't wait till the next version comes out with a round head on it. But that will conclude. Actually, let me go outside really quick. as we go through my apartment building. Let's see if we can get this. Might be a little bit windy outside, guys, but let's try 250 lumens on the side of the building here. Nice and dark. Boom, it's 250 lumens. Lights that tree up pretty good. Now, I'm not quite sure how charged this light was. Might be on like a 50% charge right now. They do come with a slight charge on them, but I do suggest, I'll put it down, bring it back up. I do suggest that you guys charge it fully before using it. But other than that, light works great. My thoughts are, get yourself one. They're cheap, very compact, very portable, very strong light too. So stainless steel, very, very good light. So I'll go up top for final thoughts. All right, guys, now we're up top for my final thoughts. I'd like to give you guys a show of all four colors that are available. This is the blue. Nice anodized blue. Now, I'm not sure if you guys can tell. Let me put my finger on there and lift it up. The blue one and the rainbow are kind of fingerprint magnets. But for a keychain light, who really cares, right? They look great. There's a black one. It's like a black washed brushed stainless steel look to it, basically. Like a little bit of fingerprints on too, I guess. Then we have the silver. The silver is almost one of my favorites, actually. It's a brushed stainless steel. Very, very neat. Let me see if this guy will turn on. Yes, he will. Now, they do come with a slight charge, like I said before, but when you guys first get it, I do recommend that you charge it completely. That way you guys get the full use of the light itself without any mishaps or it running out on you guys. But final thoughts is, great light. Again, you can get this from Banggood, if you like, as the Astrolux K1. Exact same light. I will also post a link to where you guys can get the actual Matt Minko, the original CSF02. And again, if you guys liked the video and enjoyed it, please give it a thumbs up and please subscribe for more future videos. They're coming up very, very soon. So until the next one, guys, take care.